Well, good morning, everybody. It's Friday at the ass end of January. Is it the 29th today? Yeah, could be. Could be. So we're right at the tail end of this month anyway. And just on my way to do a little short run. I don't know where I'm going to go actually. Do I need to go and get a couple of bags of coal first, or do I need to go to Blandford and get some of the yogurt and some bread? And I also need fuel as well. Then I think I'll go to Blandford. I was going to go to Poole until I realised it was Friday. Had it been Thursday, yes, I would have gone. I would have been on my way to Poole now. Uh-oh. Oh, looky, looky, a big man. I don't know where he's going to make me go backwards. Oh, nice one, buddy. Nice one. Clever boy, aren't you? He's a clever boy. We just hope nothing comes up the hill behind me, that's all. See, that wasn't difficult, was it? He didn't pull into the widest part of that little... Oh no, not another one. This is ridiculous. I almost wish I hadn't bothered, man. I certainly pick my times, don't I? Okay, so no music today, so they can't even give me anything approaching a copyright claim like they will on the one that I've got uploading. Oh my God almighty, what is going on here today? I'll make it Blandford. It's just by way of getting out and riding the boat, which I'm perfectly entitled to do as long as I put fuel in it. Nobody's going to be telling me I can't be out and about exactly as and when I want to be, whatever time I want to be out. They can shut their lockdowns where the sun don't shine. I'll leave it at that for your imaginations. We're sure to get a plonker in here asking,
"Sir, you need to wear a mask."
No, I don't. You need to mind your own business, pal. Get up my face. This lake down here where I've just come through literally is a huge lake, and just here on this corner the half the road was underwater because they came out once and they couldn't be asked to clear the drains properly, so there must have been quite a kerfuffle about it. And it was a hazard, I mean it was right on a blind bend at a low point between two opposing gradients, and it was actually a dangerous situation. Blandford's further away, but hey, I don't mind, I'm out for the ride. Oh, the snowdrops are out, folks. It's not the end of January quite, and the snowdrops have been out for a few days. I don't know what you can see amongst all this crap and litter that's on the side of the roads, but yeah, there are little clumps of snowdrops. There's some there on the left, just like past. And I like to see them, it's nice. Shandula, Shanduli. Oh, I'm going to switch my sign on. Shandula. There you go. It's fine, I'm talking to myself, but there's nobody else to talk to, so I don't have a lot of choice. And I don't like to sit here in silence, particularly. Normally I would have music playing, which is kind of nice, but as I say, because YouTube are such babies, such controlling freaks, I just can't be asked for copyright strikes. The only reason I use YouTube is because it is so well used and it's a convenient platform, but I mean they're a bunch of shit in the yard. It was more rain folks. Well, I've got the dash cam on, so you'll be seeing this whole journey and hearing it. Oh, 31 miles an hour. This little place is called Hinton St. Mary. You probably already know that by now, after all the videos I've posted. Travelling videos I put up. Probably nobody's much interested, but I don't care. It's my channel. I put up what I want on my channel. People can either watch or not watch. I don't twist anybody's arms. The reason I actually have the dash cam, apart from the obvious, which is to record any incidents, which seems to be the thing nowadays, I just like recording the journeys. Most of my journeys, in fact all of them, have been incident free, and I hope it stay that way. People seem to go out looking for trouble, looking for reasons to put their videos on YouTube. I don't. I just put up the boring A to B and B to A videos because I like the driving. I enjoy driving, I enjoy being out and about. Can't beat it. Driving, they've got to be in, these people are definitely four or five sandwiches short of a picnic. That's a good place to park, right on a bastard bed. Very sensible. Very sensible. So long next time. I'm like, so we'll turn around again in a minute. Later now. And he stood there farting around with that shop, painting or whatever. Weather. Ooh, better rather you can meet the pally. I got right away, so I'm going. Breezy morning this morning, or afternoon. Is it morning or afternoon? It's just about morning still, according to my clock. I could be wrong. It's breezy, rainy, and not particularly warm. So all in all, the typical winter's day. Or at least the typical winter's day here in good old UK. There's nothing united, and it's certainly not a kingdom. Don't want it to be either. The river's up quite high. We must have had quite a bit of water coming down from the sky last night. Shout out, I know I'm not doing this live, well I'm live as I'm saying this, because obviously I am live as I'm doing this, but it won't be live when it goes out to YouTube obviously. But I'm going to give a shout out to all my 557 subscribers. Well, I can't give them a shout out because I don't know where most of them are, but I will just say thank you very much for subscribing to me. I appreciate your subscriptions. Even if you don't watch my content, it's nice if you subscribe because it does help. It will help me get up to that magic 1,000. Or slightly a bit more, hopefully. So I can then use my mobile facility and actually do live streams as per actual live stream, as opposed to live recorded live streams, if you know what I mean. So anyway, this road surface is getting worse day by day. Coming into Fiddleford, you've got Fiddleford Manor down here on the left, where this little junction is. There's nothing to write home about. I've never been in there, but it's not that huge. Well, I expect it's okay, but nothing particularly great. Just going round the right-hand bend now, well under my 40 miles an hour limit. I wouldn't like to live in that cottage there, where those boards are, especially after seeing the number of people that went through hedges in my Bristol foray, which is still being uploaded because I missed it. It flew, it caught the push of air from the front of the vehicle, so it pushed it up over the top. I didn't hear any noise, so it didn't hit. That was a goldfinch, I think. But anyway, it was a close call, but I didn't hit it. I don't like to hit anything while I'm driving. I don't even like to hit rats or shoot the bloody things at home because they're relentless. But out here, no, they're no problem to anybody. And I wouldn't like to kill something when it can be avoided, which is partly why I've gone vegetarian, I think. Well, that reminds me too, I'd better try and buy some more while I'm down here. It would make sense to top up my food supply with vegetarian stuff for the week, so yeah, I'll do that. But it's all good, it's all good. I said this is going to be a short little trip. The Bristol one obviously is quite a lot, bit longer. It's about 4 hours in length. Taking into account that I stopped over 4 hours because I obviously didn't go straight up there and come straight back, although I didn't spend that long up there. It's just something to do, and I also wanted to check out a tyre that I've had repaired to make sure it was A-OK, and obviously it is, because shilling stone. It obviously is, because it's still inflated. That was a good run for it, a good running in for that tyre. Sprayed everything with WD-40. I used WD-40 on the vinyl up here, and I wish to God I hadn't, because it stinks. It's really, you know, it's not an unpleasant smell, but it's not a nice smell, if you know what I mean, and it kind of is like, it lingers. I just wish I hadn't done it. Oh, they're still messing around with whatever they're doing here. It's supposed to be sewage work, so I don't know what it is, but whatever it is, they're faffing around. The lights have only just changed too. We've got these barriers up and these signs out and the cones and everything. I've never seen anybody actually do anything. Where are these people hiding away? That's what I want to know. There's just nobody out doing anything. Oh, that was a quick change. Did you see that? That was ultra fast. It went from red straight almost to green. It kind of bypassed the yellow in the middle. You know, a flash, a quick flash of about half a second, then straight on to the green. That's good. Yeah, there's just nobody working here. I don't quite see what the hell they're supposed to be doing. There you go. might be not the reason why. Pedal boy. Bearing in mind I'm limited to 50 miles an hour on any road except for dual carriageways and motorways or freeways, you would call them over there in the good old US of A. On any other road, this vehicle is limited to 50 miles an hour, which really is fast enough for these type of roads. Probably too fast on some of them. put it down to heart, because that is a load of bullshit and lies. Same as NASA is all about lies, and CERN is all lies. Mankind thinks he's more powerful than he is. We're not going to affect the weather. The Almighty is the only one that can do that. It's his show, it's his call every time. Just about to cross the Stour again for the second time. There will be a third time when I go to Tesco's. That water's flowing quite fast. Let's tilt the camera down so you can get a little view of it. You should be able to see it there. The river. The muddy looking river. Let's put the camera back to where it belongs. I didn't indicate. Oh, naughty me. No, neither did the person behind me either. But that's all right, it's not a problem. I always go into Blandford, except for the rare occasions when it doesn't make sense to go into Blandford, depending on my destination. But normally, I always go into Blandford on the original old road, which is the one I should be going in on today. A lot of people would go straight up over the bypass, but I'm not going to do that. A, because there's no point. Okay, I got a rougher road as regards a road surface, but I don't mind that. I go through town. It's a bit more interesting than going up on a bypass. This is the original Blandford Road. This used to be the main road where all traffic coming down to the south coast of Poole in Bournemouth, heading in from the Bristol Warminster direction. All that traffic used to be funneled down through here, and it was a nightmare. Imagine the traffic jams with caravans, trailers, boats being towed and all that sort of thing. You can imagine what a nightmare it would have been on top of the normal everyday traffic. So yes, it was. It wasn't a pleasant road to drive. I used to drive it for many years. I've got no footage of it because there wasn't such things as dash cams back then. Recording journeys by road wasn't a priority. Well, not a priority now. It wasn't a thing. Let's put it that way. It wasn't a thing then. So I've got to give way here. It's a bit crazy having to give way on an upwards gradient. It should be the other way around, but of course these councillors are idiotic, they don't know, they haven't got any common sense. Common sense is a thing that's lacking. All run by brain dead bureaucrats. They've been to university and college, which makes them idiots basically, because they got no idea about reality. They live in this fantasy world and try and impose their fantasy bullshit on everybody else. This imaginary fucking bug is supposed to be going on. Ugh, these stupid bloody speedos. No need of them at all. There's a 20 mile an hour limit through here. Go on, just go. I'm gonna slow down for the crossings anyway, because they're too much of a lump to go over at any speed. It will definitely not do your suspension. Any whatsoever. Well, considering there is supposed to be such a pandemic, this hospital has remained, as it always has done, remarkably quiet. There's nothing going on, so show me all the bodies. Believers in the scandemic, which it is a scandemic. Scam as in S-C-A-M, not P-A-N. Good old Blandford town. I quite like this little town actually. I've got no reason not to like it at this moment. Apparently there's a big bit of a drugs problem down and out. Ne'er-do-wells on the streets, but I think you get that in any place. Oh, these mask weeds. Freaking crazy. The new normal. This is your new normal, you fools. Look at her. I get to see somebody not wear a robe. She's not got one. He hasn't. But there's a few sane people about then, apparently. But they're few and far between. I'll get the fuel first. That makes the most sensible alternative, I think. The less time I've got chilled stuff hanging about in here, the better. So yeah, I'll get the fuel first and then I will do the shopping. Go in there, turn left in there. Over the Stour again, just about to. Well, where that white car is, or that white brown car at the moment. Here we go, up over the Stour again. You can see by the water flow, it's going left of me. On down to Christchurch, where it meets the sea. House, the Brewers, which is right here, makers of Badger beers. I've never been a beer drinker myself. In fact, I very rarely touch alcohol at all in any way, shape or form. But I've never liked beer, never been a fan of it. CM Tires, a good company. shall get it here. Yeah, I'll get it here. Okay, this is where I put some fuel in. Unfortunately, the audio was a little bit unusable from this point, so I've decided to do a voice fill-in. Just one of those things that occurs every now and again. So we're now on our way to the store, pick up a bit of shopping, and you will probably get the audio back again in a minute. The road surface was particularly bad, it really is rough. Anyway, I think that just about takes us back into the usable audio again. Why don't they sort these fucking roads out? People don't pay enough already to keep the roads up together. Oh, they worry about fucking minutiae and fucking stuff that's just bullshit, but stuff that is required to be done, they just bypass it.
We got no money.
Well, what do you do with the fucking money you rob off bus and taxes and fucking all the other shit you charge and bunch of bastards. This is a shit a lot of them. Alright. Let's go and do what we gotta do anyway. It's a friggin' nightmare. Okay folks, well, I'm having a usual gripe. Not that I need to, because I haven't paid and I'm not going to pay. Like I said, these fucking councils are a bunch of shite. We're putting business into this town by coming here and buying stuff. I'm fucked if I'm going to pay for the privilege of spending money. Yeah, they can fuck right off. Sorry, but I ain't going for that. Well, just been into Morrison's and I didn't get accosted this time, which was a fucking pleasant change. A very pleasant change. Clear from the left. Oh, we're not clear from the right now, but we are now. Nobody said a dicky bird to me, and that's the way it should be. I don't appreciate being accosted for just going about my business which is not their fucking business. I'm helping to pay their wages. I don't appreciate being accosted because I won't fucking follow their bullshit fucking lies of wearing a fucking muzzle. No, ain't gonna happen. It's never gonna happen. Still pushing this shit, and there's still the morons are still wearing these fucking muzzles on their faces like the brain dead twats they are. Should be ashamed of themselves. Alright, well, I've got done what I needed to get done. I've got my bits and pieces, I got some fuel in here again. Good. Well, this thing does a lot better on a run than it does just little local pops like down here. But at least it's nothing too horrific. It gets me to where I need to go. Away, so I don't know what you're thanking me for, but it's kind of you anyway. I'm over a ramp, not too great at the rate of knots. Slowly up and over, that's the way to do it. Well, at least I didn't get wet. I held off while I was going to and from the store, which is good. Up and over, up and over. You don't notice on the camera, but it's a quite a big hump those crossways, pedestrian crossways. Apart from the stupid, ridiculous little humps like this I got in front of me now, which are utterly pointless. I mean, those people that are going to speed aren't going to take too much notice of them anyway. They're going to either steer between them or just not care, so don't really bother. Up and over, but the crossway humps are quite large. I got right away this time, so I didn't even have to think about stopping. Return journey then. What if they sold this place yet? Oh no, it's still up for sale. Oh, it's 2 houses by the look of it. I thought it was one big one. Not a nice place to live. You're hemmed in by trees. You're right in the bottom of a valley. It's always cold and damp. You don't get the sun. Nah, not a place I'd want to live. I feel too hemmed in. If you saw the state of this thing, it's absolutely plastered in crap because I took a trip up the road to Bristol a couple of days ago and it was wet and misty, but it's more miserable than it is today down here. It's quite decent actually here, apart from the fact that it's not very warm. But hey ho, we're just coming up onto the A350. There's not a lot on this road today. Don't have to. There's nothing come down the hill at all. You can't see because I'm looking in the mirrors, so you can't see that. You want to get get by quickly, didn't you, with little ships? But it's, it's not a very heaven-used road, I suppose, all the snowflakes are staying home. Idiot, wearing a mask.
Moron.
Fucking ambulance driver wearing a mask. There's got to be something wrong with these people. Very wrong. According to what I've seen, I don't know, you can't trust politicians, obviously, because they're all in bed with their master Satan, but they're talking about extending this so-called lockdown into July. This shit is never going to end. As long as people put up with it, as long as they obey the crap, it's not going to go away.
Can't wait for this to end so we can get back to normal.
Well, friends, you've got a very unpleasant bit of news coming your way. It ain't going to get better because it ain't going to go away because fools like you are wearing the fucking muzzles and believing the bullshit you get fed, spoon-fed, bucket-fed by the stinking lying media. So as long as you go on believing that fucking rubbish, this shit is not going away, all right? There you are, I told you. For those of you fucking idiots that wear masks. Keep wearing them and keep enjoying your repression and your fucking slavery. Because once you kowtow to this shit, you'll kowtow to having family members that don't agree with you being reported, probably by you, like some little jerk-off kid reporting his father for something or other, that some COVID fucking breach. I mean, the Bible tells us this. Children will turn against their parents, and we're seeing it. It's being acted. The Bible prophecies are being enacted as you live and breathe. And if you can't see that, then you need to wake the fuck up rather quickly. This is part of the great deception. One of the biggest deceptions there's been is convincing us all we live on a spinning fucking ball, which is absolute fucking eyewash. Look! Oh, bloody, these birds are taking a getting a bit chancy today. Just missed that picture, man. Drive at any huge speeds, so they've got more of a chance of surviving if they come near me than would some people. Off the gas completely. now we're coming to our roll-in speed limit, or our roll-in speed, which is 30, almost down to 30. Now we're down to 30. Fuck off sign, I was doing 30, it was probably the crap behind me. It just comes on and flashes 30. But if people keep their eyes open, they should see the bloody signs anyway. And the markings on the road. Which clearly state the limit of speed you're allowed to go up to. You don't have to be on it, but you have to be within parameters of going up to it. Because it says 30 doesn't mean you have to do 30. You could do 25. You could do 20. You could do 15 if you want to be a real jerk, but you know. There you go. Within our speed limit. Guess what? We've caught those bloody lights again on red. And there's a little shit that couldn't wait to get past me, and he got caught as well, so it didn't do him a lot of good, did it? Spots of rain every now and again, and sometimes it comes down, sometimes it doesn't. It's just very sporadic little showers. Yeah, they've done sweet fanny all here for weeks. There's just nothing going on at all. Noticed is the very fluid passage of people selling houses and moving about. It's a very fluid situation as far as population is concerned out here. There doesn't seem to be any cohesive centres or places of population where people stay maybe for their entire lives. It's all very, what's the word I'm looking for, is nomadic. It seems to be getting very nomadic, which is a little bit unsettling, or it is for me anyway. Oh, okay, it's not me that's moving, but it just unsettles the place because there's no cohesive population. You don't really get to know who your neighbours are too well. I'm lucky with my immediate neighbours. They've been there a long time. And the newest one's been there 10 years. So that is like reasonable, you know. But you go through these places and you see places up for sale, for rent, sold, for sale. It's like people just don't seem to want to stay in one place for any length of time. I mean, surely if you have the means to buy somewhere to live, which is a major, major commitment in your life, I would imagine you scope the place out fairly well before you actually move into it. I don't know, perhaps I'm just being a bit cynical. But I would actually scope the place out, the area, and decide whether I liked it or not before I went through a major, probably the major biggest thing you're going to go through in this life of uprooting and actually going somewhere, setting down supposedly roots, but people don't seem to want to put roots down anywhere. And I'm wondering if this is not part of the ploy of just unsettling the population, so there's no sense of community anymore. People are just isolating themselves from each other because they don't know each other. And by the time you do try and get to know somebody, they're off again. There seems to be something mighty spiritual as opposed to just the physical. That's just me, maybe I'm wrong on that, but I don't think I am. I think it's the 29th today, but I'm not going to swear to it. I don't really follow the calendar too much because one day is very much like another. Traffic on these lights today, and the river is quite high. It's in flood at the moment. I have seen it a lot worse than this. It sometimes come out and encroaches on the road. That's a major, major flood. It might well happen. We're getting to break. Consistent and persistent rain. The thing with this river, which is called the Stour, it rises and falls very quickly. It doesn't stay particularly normal level. It just drops and rises according to the rainfall, and it does it very quickly, as I'd say. I mean, it's in flood, but a couple of days, if there's no more rainfall, then it'll be back to its usual level. Or more usual level, I should say. Back into Sturminster Newton. Medieval town, twinned with Montyburg, wherever the hell that is. What's that wagon doing up there? That rid of your wagon. Does it want to come down the road or what's it doing? Those are faffing around, don't want to come down the road. That's good, Dan. The road is narrow up through here. It wasn't built for modern day traffic, obviously. The houses have been around a lot longer than the amount of traffic. There used to be several banks. That used to be NatWest on the left that I'm passing right now. That's been closed ages. And there was a Barclays just up here, which is the other Portland stone building with a seat outside of it. That used to be, Lloyd's that used to be. That also was closed. Oh good, the dry cleaners is open. That means I can bring my duvet down and get it clean. Great stuff. Station. So just a small little single engine I think they got in there. Of course you Americans, a single ladder. But that is it. I think, you know, it's not big enough to house much else in there. Maybe a car or two, I don't know. Like most fire stations, especially something here, they can be fairly sure that they're not going to be doing much during most days that go by. Oh, that is going to cause some real problems. That is basically suffocating you. Anybody that does that really should be locked up for their own safety and for the safety of people around them, because that is beyond insane. Well, this whole thing is beyond insane, but that, I'm afraid, doubles it. Exponentially doubles it. Reside. Just park up. I was going to go and get some bags of coal, but I can't really be bothered. I have the option of the electric heater anyway for the Shabbat, so I'm not too bothered. Latest Iveco look. I reckon they're ugly. Like most of the modern things are really ugly looking vehicles. I much prefer the Mark III version that I've got. Old though it may be, relatively old. It's new to me. Newest vehicle I've ever had. Probably the last I shall ever have too, but that suits me. As long as I can just about keep it on the road, then I'll stay on the road. It might even outlive me. Swim through great huge puddles. The council are so marvellous, they're so fast in their actions, only taken up a lot of time before to clear that drain, and still there you are. At least they've done it now, hopefully it'll stay clear. Many times, this little drive up this little narrow road. If you've watched any of my videos, this whole place was built for farm traffic. The roads were built for farm traffic, not before, obviously. These latter days. I drive would be considered a large vehicle around here. It's not particularly large, it's only a 17-seater. That includes my ass as well, of course. And when I say 17-seater, it's actually a 16. Awkward little junctions, awkward little turn-ins, but I cope with it. Uh, and here's our little parking space coming up in front of this little black thing. And there's the exciting bit, the reversing. About it, and folks, end of the video.